Hi, my name is Phillip Slater, and today I'm going to talk about slow-moving inventory. Slow-moving inventory is often seen as something of an easy target for people who are trying to undertake an inventory review. And rather than undertake a structured process like the inventory cash release process, they target a single type of inventory, such as slow-moving inventory. There's often a perception that the fact that the inventory is slow means that perhaps it's not quite required or not required anymore. Now, this is mistaken because the fact that it's required infrequently doesn't mean it's no longer required, and it might need to be held in some quantity of stock because of supply conditions. So being slow is not a sufficient reason to review a particular item. Now, I believe that people's perception of slow-moving inventory can be traced back to the definition that's often used for defining slow-moving inventory. Sometimes companies define slow-moving as having more than, say, 12 months stock on hand. So therefore, what they've really got is overstocked inventory, not necessarily slow-moving inventory. By classifying the inventory based on how much stock is on hand rather than the frequency of movement, they're not really defining the inventory as slow moving, it's really overstocked. So a better definition, in my view, is to say, well, how often is the item moving? And what might be slow in one company might not be slow for another. So to some extent, the definition depends on your particular circumstance. So if you have something where you only move one item in, say, one quarter, then you might say that's slow. In some instances, people might say it's slow if they only move one in a year. In others, it might be if they don't move one in a year, if the period's longer than that. It really depends on the circumstance of your organisation and your industry. But the key thing is to be able to define the inventory based on the frequency of movement rather than the quantity on hand. Now, one of the other problems with slow-moving inventory is the way people calculate their requirements. Often they leave this calculation up to their existing inventory software, and the software usually can't differentiate between fast and slow moving. So as a result, it defaults to using a Gaussian or normal distribution for doing the calculations. But for slow moving inventory, this is inappropriate because you're unlikely to have sufficient data points in order to be able to make a sensible calculation. A better way to calculate what's required for slow-moving inventory is to use a Poisson function. Now, a Poisson function enables you to calculate the probability of having a stock out during the restock period, depending on how many items you have on hand. And it gives you far more clarity about how to manage your slow-moving inventory. So what should you do in order to improve the management of slow-moving inventory? Well, the first thing you should do is check the definition you're using for defining slow-moving inventory. Is it based on the quantity held or the frequency that the items are actually moving? And you should correct that. That might dispel a lot of myths about slow-moving inventory in your business. The second thing to do is to check what calculation is being used to determine the reorder point. Are you defaulting to using a Gaussian function through your software system, or is someone calculating that with a Poisson function? Now, once you've worked those two things out, the third thing to do is to apply that new knowledge and that new understanding to determining what's the right holding levels for the inventory that you've got. And the last thing that I'd recommend is that you actually put in flags in your system so you can differentiate between things that are slow moving and things that are becoming obsolete. So sometimes an item may be obsolete, it's not picked up in the system, it appears to be slow moving, and then nothing's done about it till eventually someone says, hey, you know this thing's obsolete? So there's four actions that can help you improve the management of your slow moving inventory. But remember that this is not going to be a substitute for a proper review of your inventory holdings. It won't solve all your inventory problems. Now, if you do want to solve your inventory problems, you need to undertake a proper, structured approach to reviewing the inventory that you've got. And if you'd like more information about that, you can visit the website that's shown here on the screen.